This statue looks a little like Amadeus's wife when she gets cross.
Oh, I think you're right.
Thank you.
What do these creatures eat?
There must be something in the water here. Or maybe it's in the soil.
Can't wait to find out what.
Dear Rosie, I'm so sorry I didn't notice you leaving the party. Happy 16th, my love. Let's go to the forest tomorrow through the secret cavern. Isabel.
Their demise now seeming certain, the heroes fell through the cold darkness of the caverns. Total blackness enveloped them like the jaws of some indescribable monster. Where was the trine now? Danger lurks ahead. Thank you.
Where the waters fall, my darling, let's rest. Sleep here by my side. I still love you best. While in the caverns, Pontius had picked up some mushrooms, but Zoya and Amadeus persuaded him not to eat them. Amadeus recalled a time when he had made a mushroom potion in his school days. Indeed, that had not ended well. As the heroes climbed out of the caverns, they met with the first light of morning.
A beautiful dawn.
Rosabelle's castle shouldn't be far now.
There's some huge hairy fruit up in those trees.
They're called coconuts.
So there's some huge hairy nuts?
No, they're fruit.
Shouldn't they be called cocoa fruit then?
I don't know.
Is this quite safe?
My sister is sweet, while I am unseen. But she is not strong. I should be queen.
This is going to require timing.
Dreadful weather. Birthday celebrations were lavish. Sadly, they were disrupted by Princess Rosabelle, who felt she had been slighted by her gifts. Princess Isabel received a golden gown, a diamond tiara, and a pair of silk gloves. Princess Rosabelle received a silver gown, a moonstone necklace, and a pair of lace gloves. Did you know that the octopus has three hearts?
Hey, that's just like us.
Thank you, Mr. Octopus. It's Lady Rosabelle.
Well, well. She wasn't lying about being queen.
Zoya, a noble lady like her wouldn't tell lies.
Uh-huh.
So, action! Yeah.
Finish them! Useless minions! Shoot! Face the might of Goblin King!
Leave this cosmos or face my hammer! Yes, you toad!
At last. I'll keep his crown if you don't mind.
Hurrah! We've cleared the halls for Her Majesty!
And our own kingdom will soon be safe. Shall we head back to the house?
Not so quick. I want to take a look around first.
Oh, must we?
Look, this is Isabel. It's got her name on it.
Yes, Rosabelle's sister. The one who used to own the portal locket.
So where is she now?
Dear Isabel, happy 18th. Congratulations also for becoming the crown princess and heir to the throne. To celebrate, I have a surprise in the cellars. It's a big secret. Tell no one. Go through the laundry room. I'll meet you there, Rosabelle.
The artifact of souls. It's imbued with great power. I could use it to bring you back and restore the kingdom.
Come on, let's follow it.
After the battle with the Goblin King, the heroes searched the castle. They found strange clues hinting of another princess. It seemed that Isabel and Rosabelle had been close once, but what had happened to them? Despite Amadeus's reluctance, Zoya led them to the cellars to uncover secrets left in the dark.
We'll take a quick look around and then come back to the surface fast, right?
Run for your lives! What an appalling nightmare is this! Trine! Come back and take me home! I can't take this anymore!
It's probably just a little bitty part of a giant crab.
Little? This? You're not helping. And now acid?
It won't eat through my shield. I just had it acid-proofed at the smithy last week.
Thank you. Thank you. My sister is lost. The night has begun. Only one can be queen when all's said and done.
Watch out!
This isn't doing anything.
Hear that? It sounds like it's jammed or broken.
Looks like another job for the wizard.
Thank you.
Let's go and try it out. Dear Rosie, happy 18th. I was as surprised as you are by the announcement. We should talk, Isabel.
I'm really starting to feel uncomfortable about this.
What? The smell?
Hunting for long-lost treasure in a sewer filled with these things.
Thank you. This looks like one of Rosabelle's mirrors.
Rosie, where are you?
Isabel?
Lady Princess, come back!
Let's follow her.
While trying to save their kingdom, the heroes had been drawn into a tangle of intrigue and mystery. Following the elusive shadow of Isabel, the heroes stepped through Rosabelle's mirror. As they passed through the portal, they felt a freezing cold touch, leaving them chilled to the bone.
I'm so grateful that you've slain the Goblin King. Now, please, hand over the trine.
We can't do that even if we wanted to. It's bound to us.
I see. Where is your sister? Poor Isabel. I'm afraid her magic has cursed the forest. But if you give me the artifact, we can remove the enchantment for good.
No, we'll come with you and face her together.
I'm afraid I can't allow that.
And now we're trapped.
Well, well, what have we here? The goblin-hating adventurers locked up in our dungeons. You'll never get out, not while I have you in my sight.
Then let's get out of his sight. Get out of this place, wherever we are.
Yes, and find out what's going on with Rosabelle and her sister.
This Isabel makes the trees and plants grow back home. Why would she do that?
Maybe she's a wicked, cackling witch gone mad.
But it's Rosabelle who took her and locked her up somewhere.
But princesses ought to be nice and lovely, not tearing each other's hair or destroying kingdoms over crowns.
Thank you.
It's like the forge all over again.
Forest has reached a human kingdom in the far west. They are rich with fat pigs and tasty sheep. No more snails. We go in the cover of forest, attack in the dark, and steal all their pigs. Oh, and their pies. And their pies. Their ales. And their women.
Ales?
Shh.
thick ice. My hammer's no good here.
Summer is gone with all its roses, its sun and sights of sweetest flowers, its foliage and July showers, and now the autumn closes. Soon autumn's windy days are going, and darker days are ever colder, each day dimmer as time grows older, but spring waits in the earth, unknowing.
Dear Isabel, it's best for us both if you stay here for a while. I intend to be queen. I'm much better at it. Don't try to escape. You will be cared for during your stay. Rosabelle.
As the heroes read the letter, the kingdom's fate suddenly made sense. Rosabelle had taken Isabel's place as the crown princess, but something had gone wrong, and their kingdom had ended up in ruins and overtaken by goblins.
That sorceress! She'll meet the end of my sword if she dares show her face again.
This icy slope will be the death of us.
Stops here.
And it's a long way down.
How are we going to get away? Help me, little tree. Grow your branches long and strong so I may pass.
Isabel? She made the tree grow.
As if by magic.
The heroes had discovered that Isabel was indeed Rosabelle's sister. The journey back to Rosabelle's house took the trio down the side of a mountain and through the perilous haunted forests. Now their progress was made swifter, for it seemed as if the whole forest had come alive to help them get back safely. Hoping to catch Rosabelle off guard, they made their way to a balcony high atop the petrified tree.
Let's storm this lair!
From the highest tower of conquest, my victories are thrown, and grief and pain are my hopes, since all the world is gone. Flow, tears, from your springs, my failures ever let me mourn. Where nighttime bird in darkness sings, there let me live forlorn.
kind of sad. They look so happy together.
Wait! There's something behind this picture. Look here.
Princess Isabel!
Your saviors are here!
Your Majesty, wake up!
Can you hear us?
Are you hurt, Princess?
We'll free you in a moment!
The heroes yelled and called for the Princess, but she did not stir from her death-like slumber.
She can't hear us. She seems unconscious. Of course, the enchanted sleep spell. It's almost irreversible.
You shouldn't be here.
So, the artifact of souls is bound to you three. I wonder what happens to it when you all die.
The artifact will never help you.
You'll never get away with this, whatever your crooked plan is.
Silence, you rabble!
I didn't intend for the forest to steal Isabel's powers. But with your artifact, I can bring order back to this land. First, I need to get rid of you three. Let me introduce you to my little pet.
Sleeping princess began to untangle and withdraw.
What is happening? Am I alive? Rosie!
The amazed heroes saw Rosabelle fall down into the underground lake. Isabel dived after the sinking shadow of Rosabelle. After a moment, Isabel returned, carrying her sister.
Thank you for freeing me, heroes.
Pleased to meet you, Lady Princess.
If only the circumstances could be more cheerful.
Rosie, she was always very stubborn.
Can we get you anything? A towel?
I just want to go home.
I'm afraid your castle lies in ruins.
Not to mention you've some grave issues with your plumbing.
How are we going to get out of here?
The portals are all gone now.
Just then, the trine appeared and shed its golden light around the cavern. The light grew warmer and brighter, wrapping everyone with an invisible blanket of comfort and safety. The cavernous tunnel vanished from their sight. The trine brought our heroes back to the very forest where the wizard and the knight had met at the beginning of the journey.
We did what we set out to do. Our kingdom is safe, and the forest has turned back to normal.
How did we do that?
It was Isabel's magic that affected the forest. Now that she's free, the balance has been restored.
No! I forgot to bring that magic water with me for the potatoes.
Here, I have a whole skin full of magic water.
Zoya! You're a decent sort after all.
It'll cost you 5 gold.
What? You already got a crown today?
The three heroes spent the night talking of the great adventure before they headed back home. So the princess and the pumpkins had been rescued, and the great adventure drew to a close.